Last summer, David Casale was busy running the cybersecurity firm he had started 18 years earlier, but he found himself increasingly preoccupied and disturbed by the news from Syria. He would watch the 10 o'clock bulletin with mounting dismay. There was a sense of horror at seeing hospitals being bombed and kids being killed, and then seeing it slip down the news agenda. I had a sense of total powerlessness. Most people have probably had similar feelings of helplessness when confronted with catastrophic footage from war zones, but Casale's response was unusual. He decided to sit down and compose a requiem, hoping to raise money for Syrian charities from performances. I couldn't go on watching the television and seeing Aleppo. I thought I'd like to do something through music and dance. I went to bed every night at 10, got up at 4 and wrote for 3 hours. A year later, Requiem for Aleppo has become a powerful and moving show. It premiered at London's Sadler's Wells in April, raising £80,000, most of which will be used to train teachers in Syria. Casale has now sold his business and is planning to take the production to the Middle East, the US and Canada. The piece, which he describes as a personal lament for those innocently caught up in the horror, is in Edinburgh this week, having been nominated for an Amnesty International Freedom of Speech Award. Reflecting Aleppo's diverse cultural heritage, the music draws together Arabic, Christian, Berber and Jewish influences. It includes Christian Requiem Mass lyrics set to choral music as well as early Arabic poetry, beautifully sung by Giuliano Yazbek and Abdul Salam Kerr. The work is broken up with the voices of Aleppo residents describing the fighting and their flight from what the UN has described as the biggest humanitarian crisis of our time. Haunting, Requiem for Aleppo in Edinburgh. Photograph Tim Hall. Casale makes it sound as if it was easy to juggle running a company with composing this piece. 4 in the morning in spring and summer is the best time to be thinking about music, he says. Although it was a huge step away from his professional life, Casale has always been interested in music. He plays the guitar and has a second career as a singer-songwriter. In 2014, he released his debut album Out of the Light, under the name Cas Benedict. Most of Requiem was composed on his guitar, while musician Rasmus Anderson helped score the work. Jason Mabana, a recent Rambic graduate, was brought in to choreograph a piece of contemporary dance that would evoke the immense human suffering of Syria's population and the chaos of the war. Sponsorship from the Lindbury Trust and the said foundation funded the dancers' wages and production costs, meaning ticket money can go straight to Syria relief. The team of 12 dancers, 8 women and 4 men were recruited from around the world, and their extraordinary performance makes this a hard-hitting, haunting piece. The constant running is a powerful image. It suggests the struggle, the need to run away for the duration of the show. Each dancer takes turns running on the spot, sometimes center stage, sometimes at the edge, desperately trying to flee from an unseen disaster. It is a potent, emotionally taxing theme, as the performers become wearier and more hopeless but struggle to keep going, to find safety. This makes it a challenging piece for the dancers, who are on stage most of the time. The running is a powerful image, says Casale. It is a constant. It suggests the struggle, the need to run away. But the performance is exhausting, both the intensity of the dance and because the dancers realize they are representing something of immense emotional weight. Casale, who has never been to Aleppo, was worried about how the large number of Syrians who attended the London performance would respond. I was extremely nervous that it would land right with people who have been through a great deal of pain. I was worried that they might ask who was I, who had not been to Syria, to take the recent past and make something of it. But they were incredibly positive. It allowed us to give them a voice. They felt part of their story had been heard. Casale worked with the writer Ben Faccini, interviewing 10 people talking about their lives and their flight. They are young and old, he says. Some were recorded formally with microphones in London, some over a mobile phone, or talking via WhatsApp from Turkey. The interviews, he says, were hard. But the task of editing them felt harder still, as these narratives of survival, grief and past joy come with a direct responsibility. They speak of lives lost, of suffering, of a thriving city that is no longer. But more than that, they carry an implicit message no one should take having a home, a country, for granted. No one should assume that humanity can resist violence. We hear from Haya Tatu, a 20-year-old student in the UK, who hopes to train as a doctor and return home now that we have escaped Syria. Every time we eat meat, chicken and stuff, we feel guilty, because our family and all those who are left behind cannot. Even when you are happy, you feel guilty. One day you wake up and the person who used to live next door to you has been killed by a sniper. A refugee, too nervous to be named, tells us he is longing to return home to look again at Aleppo's citadel. I'm a Syrian. I just want to go back home. I want to live with my own thoughts, with my own ideas. I want to be free to see what I want, to do what I want, just like you. Ahmed al-Rashid, an English literature student in Aleppo, fled at the height of the civil war and is now studying violence, conflict in development at SOAS University of London. If you were living in Aleppo, he says, it was not that different from London. I was at university, people were going about their everyday business, students, workers, but then you wake up and that person who used to live next to you has been killed by a sniper, or the school next door has been totally destroyed. He tries to add a positive note. Seeing all this bloodshed, seeing all this killing and brutality, did not make me hate humankind. There are a lot of people who did really horrible stuff. They killed people, they beheaded people, they burned people alive. But still I cannot hate people. If we focus on the narrative of hatred and fear, then this bloodshed will never stop. We need to focus on the narrative of humanity, of hope that things will get better tomorrow. Requiem for Aleppo is at Pleasance at EICC, Edinburgh, on the 16th of August. Details about Syria relief.